Hello everyone, I am Dr. Harshit Vaidya, a vitro-retina surgeon from Shankar Netralaya, Chennai, and I currently practice at Dr. Vaidya Hospital in Andheri. So just yesterday, I saw a patient of retinal detachment. On explaining to him, I realized that the patient was unaware of what the retina was, let alone retinal detachment. We come across this situation very often as retina specialists. We realize that patients are rather unaware or mistake the retina for a different part of the eye. With this in mind, I realized, let's make a short video on what the retina is and explain what it does. At the end of the video, I'll be sharing three common myths regarding the retina. So please stay tuned to the very end. Let's dive right into it. So this is the structure of an eyeball. As the word suggests, it's a ball-like structure. And in the front, the transparent structure that we see is the cornea. The color that the eye gets is from the structure behind the eye, behind the cornea, which is called as the iris. The white portion that we see all around, covering the entire eye, is called as the sclera. So if you were to cut open the eye, this is how the eye would look from the inside. Here, just behind the cornea, like I mentioned, is a structure, a proteinaceous structure called as the lens. In the old age, we have heard this word called as cataract. This is the structure which causes cataract. The eye gets divided into two segments because of this structure. The portion in front of it is called as the anterior segment, and the portion behind it is called as the posterior segment. This cavity that we see here is called as the vitreous cavity. This is a jelly-like structure which forms a cushion inside of the eye. The retina is a transparent, multi-layered, complex structure in the back portion of the inside of the eye. It functions similar to the film of the camera. It contains millions of neurons and cells, and as well as many, many small blood vessels. Once we dilate the pupils with dilating eye drops, the picture we see here is something what we see inside of the eye. The circular pinkish structure that we see here is called as the optic nerve. It carries all the information from the eye to the brain for the image formation. The red structures that we see here are the blood vessels of the retina. And the rest of the structure is what we call as the retina. It is mainly divided into two parts. The first is the macula. This is where the central and the color vision formation occurs. And the second part is what we call as the peripheral retina, where the peripheral vision and the night vision takes place. Now let's see how the image is formed on the retina. In short, here we see that the light coming from the candle converges on the cornea and the lens and forms a focused image on the retina and precisely on the macula. This light stimuli or the light impulse is then transformed or converted into an electrical impulse by specialized cells on the macula, which are called as the photoreceptor cells, and this is mainly located in this macular region. These electrical impulses are then transferred from the macula to the optic nerve to the brain for the conversion and the interpretation of the image. Now we'll discuss the three common myths around the retina. Myth number one, is the white portion of the eye the retina? So in this video, we have cleared that the white portion of the eye is rather the sclera and not the retina. Myth number two, do people with retinal diseases go blind each and every time? No, the answer is no. Myth number three, can the retina be replaced? So as of today, it cannot be. What we know as an eye transplant is instead a transplant of the cornea, that is the transparent portion of the eye. So in today's video, we got to learn three things. Number one, retina is a transparent structure in the back portion of the eye and not the white portion, as people confuse it for. Number two, the final image formation in the eye takes place in the retina and the image is interpreted in the brain. Number three, although the retinal diseases can be blinding, but an early and a timely intervention can indeed prevent from blindness and rather keep and maintain the stable vision. Thank you.